if we just mapped out 2020 and really looked at all of the intersecting points and some of the issues, we could find many opportunities to solve for the most pressing needs. Particularly right now, we have a system that has left us in a place where we're not able to really be with and care for our loved ones. We're hungry, we're throwing away food, we want housing, and houses sit empty inside of portfolios. There's a lot of inequity happening right now that needs creative people to solve. And so I think the times are wonderful. I think this is the time where we get to really lean into this reimagination around what would it look like if this financial system really loved Black and Brown people? What would it do? What would be the outcomes of that? And I think of the sort of in big picture of all of these things, like what would it be? I think we would be moving, to borrow your word again, Professor, opportunity. We'd be moving into an opportunity and abundance framework in the way that we built, instead of a fear and a scarcity model when we build. And I think that there is generational wealth to be had by actually thinking and moving more inside of the framework of abundance and opportunity. And that's what it would look like in the end. We would be healed. We would be healing. We would be rested. We would feel, and particularly for Black businesses and Black entrepreneurs, they would feel finally comfortable enough to stand inside of joy. And this is a big deal, because we haven't always had the luxury to not be pushing and running and doing, but to be able to sit for a moment and actually feel a joy and lean into it. That to me would be the outcome of what happens once we create this new thing.